organs for the smooth functioning of the government, that means the legislative, executive and judicial. Legislative means the law-making body of the government. That means at the central level, the law-making body is called the parliament. Parliament has two houses, that is called the Lok Sabha and the Rajya Sabha. And the members of the Rajya Sabha and Lok Sabha are called the MPs. They are making the laws for the people, for the smooth functioning of the country. And then executive, that means the law implementing body of the government is called the executive. Executive means all the executive power of authority of the government. That means the president, prime minister, and in the state level it is the governor and the chief minister and MLCs and MLCs. And in the city level it will be the local government, it is the mayor, and chairman would be the executive power authority. They are implementing the law to the people. The next one is called the judiciary. Judiciary means that here the applying law and providing justice for the people. That means it is the work is done by the court. And in the for the judiciary, at the central level it is called High Court, and in the state level it is called central level it is called the Supreme Court, and the state level it is called High Court, and in the district level it is called the District Courts. Then people are getting justice from the court. Okay, next, the functions of government are maintenance of law and order, defense the country, providing health and education, and ensuring justice, etc. That means the maintenance of law and order means that it is the duty of the policeman as well as the some other important authority of the government. They are providing that law and order for the smooth functioning of the government or the smooth functioning of the country, for the unity of the country. The next, the defense the country. The armed forces will be doing the work. That means they will be providing the friendly relationship with the other countries and protecting our country. Next, providing health and education. It is the duty of the government to provide health and education for the development of the country. That means we know that healthy and educated people are the resources of a country. That is, it is the duty of the government to provide health and education. The last, ensuring justice. That means the court will be doing the function. That means whenever people have any issue, they will be going to the court for getting the justice. Okay, this is the organs of the government and functions of the government. I hope you clear the topic. Okay, thank you.